the next part of our journey onto Phillip Island is leaving the island, popping over onto another one. We're going to Churchill Island today. Churchill Island's the home of the historic working farm to show people, I guess, what things were like back in the good old days, working on an old-fashioned farm. So looking forward to bringing you this one. It should be really interesting. So come with us as we explore Churchill Island, as we are just about coming up on the bridge which takes us over onto the island. So stand by, guys, we're going to get a great bird's eye view as we head over. Here we go. This is not attached to the mainland or Phillip Island. Churchill Island is its very own island. So here we go, guys. Over we go. Come with us as we explore the Churchill Island farm, historic homestead, and still a working farm. So we've got lots of things to see. You come into a nice centre after checking in, doing your COVID safe measures. Obviously come into a nice check-in area. They have a great gift shop here, and we'll take you up to the working farm. So here we go, guys, daily activities. We're here at 20 past one, so in a little under an hour we've got cow milking, sheep shearing, working dogs, whip cracking. So let's crack the whip and let's go. Push! Let's go! Up we go on the working farm, guys. This was an original working home. The first European settlers here in 1860. And then obviously generation after generations of people came. And this was a working farm and has been for, you know, all the time that it's been going for. So, great place. Magnificent gardens, as you can see, and still is a farm today. So it's an absolutely spectacular today. I think we picked the best weekend of weather in Victoria with no wind. Is very, very rare, especially over here. So guys, come and have a look. This is one of the main attractions for Phillip Island and the surrounding area. So come and check out Churchill Island and the working farm. Let's go and have a look. So we're coming up now to the original homestead.
Wow, that's big trees.
So that, guys, is a Norfolk Island pine brought here to Australia from the UK all those years ago. And this one was planted in 1872 by the original owners, or the first European settlers, I should say. There we go. Magnificent. Beautiful manicured gardens here, and the MS house. There it is, guys. So let's go and have a look inside. We'll take you in. Okay, let Princess lead the way. So guys, a trip back in history. This is what life was like in the 1870s, guys. So we're going back 170 odd years. Look at this, guys, original Victoria. So when the European settlers came from all over Europe, London, Ireland, UK, Wales, Scotland, settled in old homesteads like this, and this is how they decked their houses out. And this is the original furniture, guys, from 1872. Check this out. It's pretty special.
Oh, man, that's special. Over there?
It's amazing. Look at the old cuckoo clock, look, on the wall here.
And
look.
That one. Is that pelican?
Yeah, they're stuffed birds, yeah.
Oh.
Look at them. Amazing.
And this is the hospital.
There they are. So there's Elizabeth and Peter Churchill, who the island is named after. There they are up there, guys. So we'll go through and have a bit of a look.
Oh, through the house. That's cute. Look at that.
And this is, you probably can't go in there, but if you can see in there, guys, that's what a child's bedroom looked like in 1872. Fantastic, guys. No electronics, no TV, no iPhones. Just living life as it was. This was their little farm and their backyard. Alcohol. Guys, check this out. If you're wondering what it is, this is where the fragrance come from. All you do, give it a, now let me show you, just give it a little tweak with your fingers, smell your fingers and you'll smell the lavender. Absolutely magnificent.
Yeah.
It's the real deal, guys. The real deal. Oh yeah?
Bees
in there, because I make honey out of lavender flowers. Bees absolutely love lavender.
And their traditional bathroom.
Oh, here's the bathroom. There's the washing machine there, guys. So they washed it in the pot, bit of soap, bit of water, and then put it through the press, rolled the press to roll the laundry through the press and get the, I guess they would call that the rinse and the wash cycle on a washing machine. So there you go. Okay, very special moment here. Here we go, guys. Oh.
Yeah, you should try it.
All the way down. All the way down. All the way down. No, no, you're
all right. Yeah.
Very good.
Wow.
Yeah. Enough for a cappuccino
in there now. There we go. Anybody very like good. How's that?
Good.
Sign
on the other side.
So, my name's Peter, for those of you who I haven't come across yet today. And I'll give you a little rundown on some shearing, a little bit of shearing history and a little bit of shearing equipment. Now these are known as blades. So what shearing was done with up until the introduction of machine shearing or mechanical shearing, 1892. Now your average shearer with a set of blades, you would shear somewhere between 80 to 100 sheep each day. Hard work. My word. A young shearer came along by the name of Jackie Howe. Now when Jackie was just 21 years of age, he shore a world record with a set of blades. 7 hours and 40 minutes, Jackie shore 321. Which is around 90 seconds for each one. Now your average shearer today, with the equipment that we use, will shear around 200 a day. 321. So when it came out for shearers, it was like a payroll. And in 1978, David Ryan set a world record for an amperage, just like this one. In a full 8-hour day of shearing, he shore 501 Merino lambs, which is around 50 seconds for each one. And then in 2003, David Fagan, 830, which is around 35 seconds for each one. So by the time I get through, one. Today, just one. Either one of those, David, will have shorn at least four. So basically, by the time I get the belly off, I'll get the first back leg done, they're finished. So just think about that when you see me going along like an old steam train. Very slowly. Bill, I know it's Sunday, and you did work yesterday, so thank you very much for that. But see those sheep down there? Now the way he's been trained is to go around behind the sheep he's got and bring them back to me. So it doesn't matter where I walk to, you will always hopefully go around the other side.
Your name's Billy.
That's very cool.
That's good.
Good, isn't he?
Look what the
ducks
are. But that dog is really expensive.
He's 11 years old too.
Come on, Phil.
The dog is leading the cattle. See.